We just came up with the most amazing idea. Next summer, the three of us, Italy.
Okay.
To meet Angelo's family.
I have this friend who can hook us up with cheap flights. Anywhere we want to go.
Sounds great.
I will text my friend.
Oh, hey, there's better reception in the bedroom.
What are those?
Allie's in between apartments right now. So I told her that she could stay with us.
Everything okay?
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Actually, I talked to Regina, and she is not ready to meet you yet.
Oh. Okay.
Well, I want to see you, man. Let's kick it. You got it.
What are you doing?
It depends. What are you going to let me do?
I know you stabbed that kid on the bridge. My dad told me everything.
No, your dad is a liar. I didn't kill anyone, Hannah. Your dad wasn't even there.
I was worried you were embarrassed of me, and you were just using me.
When I met you at the carnival, I had no idea who you were, I swear. Look, the reason your parents were fighting about money all the time, it's because your dad was blowing it on coke.
My dad's a cokehead? Please, he's a doctor, Logan.
And that's why a jury's gonna buy it when he tells them I killed Felix. Your dad is in deep to the Fitzpatrick family, the ones who really wanted Felix dead.
And I'm supposed to believe you.
You do believe me. What I'm saying makes a lot of sense, doesn't it?
Let me go, Logan, please.
Just think about it. Check around the house, keep an open mind.
David, something happened at the Bradleys that distracted me. Duggan took her hand. And even though it took all the strength that she had left in her body, she lifted his hand to her lips and kissed it. There was an entire history in that kiss. A lifetime of love and joy and hardships and togetherness. Oh, please. And then I see you and Christy together and me getting a year older, and in the past, my mission work fulfilled me. It was everything that I needed. I almost wrote a letter back making excuses why I couldn't go. I couldn't lie to him. Not Jacob.
Do you want to see him?
I had hoped that just having him in my heart would be sufficient.
But it isn't. And you're afraid to live with a lie that not being with him doesn't matter.
We both have the same problem, don't we?
Yours is miles away, mine is sleeping upstairs. I wish I had an answer.
At least we're in good company.
What do you mean?
The great poets devoted so many sonnets to this very dilemma.
Do they have any solutions for us?
Regrettably, no. But at least their struggles are eloquently detailed.
Ooh. Everybody said, don't you feel sorry for Cactus? Many have lived longer, but few as much. Kate and I wanted to thank you for coming. We especially wanted you all here because you are all of the individuals that were involved in making the impossible possible. It's been a year since Georgie and I had our little adventure together, and we couldn't thank you publicly while Georgie was still. Well, thank you. Isaiah, my friend, my partner, my brother. Charles, what can I say? You showed Georgie and I through example what it is to be a man. I must point out, however, you're one terrible bank robber. Jerry Addison of the FBI, who was kind enough to donate his vacation time to trail us to make it feel real, but actually saved us from true outlaws. The Prescott Community Players for making it seem so real for Georgie. Of course, the Arizona First National Bank for being kind enough to let us shut them down for 20 minutes on a work day. And to the man that made this all come true for Georgie. When I came to him with my problem, he didn't act like I was crazy. He simply said, I understand. Mr. William DePasquale of the Make a Dream Come True Foundation. In just 2 short days, he organized what I thought was impossible. There were times when I actually thought he was a bad guy. He was a little too good at arranging a getaway. I thank you. Kate thanks you. Most of all, Georgie thanks you.
There's something else we tried too. About 3 months ago, we opened our relationship, you know, just to see. The rule was it was just sex, and that was all we could do with other people. And they had to know right away that we were both in a relationship.
Whose idea was that?
Oh, well, it was ours together.
You mean you both spontaneously came up with this at the same time?
No. I guess I suggested it and he agreed. I didn't want to frustrate him with my problem.
How'd you feel about that, James?
Me? I didn't think it was a good idea. Personally, I think sex is private. You don't share the person you love with anyone.
Why'd you go along with it?
I'm here now, aren't I? I guess my commitment to punishment is unwavering.
Don't say that.
Sorry.
But you two aren't open anymore.
No. It only lasted like that for a month before we changed our mind.
Were you involved with another person at the time?
He was.
Really? Who was it?
It doesn't matter.
His ex-girlfriend, Annie.
It was only once. It's not fair when you say it like that anyway. It makes me sound like an ass.
No, it doesn't.
She went out with another guy that night, so I called Annie. It's not my strongest moment, Doc. It was a mistake to do that then. This is a mistake now.